Now we offer your attention the second lecture. The topic is influence of physical exercises on human organism. Today you will account it with the new terms: hypokinesia, hypodynamia, kinesophilia. What means hypokinesia? Hypo means few, kinesia is movements. Hypokinesia means reduction of physical activity and mobility decrease, mainly in large muscles and joints. Don't confuse it with the next term, hypodynamia. In this term, dynamia means force of muscles. Hypodynamia means reduction of force and tone of muscles. For last 100 or a half and 100 years, physical activity of the people has decreased almost 20 times. And more than half of modern children grow in conditions of hypokinesia. So the widespread of hypokinesia is promoted by a number of objective and subjective factors. Objective factors are, first of all, the results of scientific and technical progress. Wide introduction of achievements of scientific and technical progress, automatization and manufacture mechanization, development of transport, application of home appliances such as computers, mobile phones, internet, TV, and so on. The next factor is urbanization. Urbanization means increasing of the people in cities. Creation of mega cities has radically changed in a parity between city and agricultural population and has led to reduction of impellent activity of urban population. The development of education, it is very actual for students, has led to involving in educational process most of children and youth. And getting education, you should read a lot, you should sit at the lectures, at practical lessons, and so it leads to hypokinetic lifestyle. The next is that some diseases demand administering for the patient strict bed rest regimen. We should try to administer it for very short period in order the patient would not suffer of the changes due to hypokinesia. You see that there are not only objective factors, but also subjective factors which lead to hypokinesia. First of them is congenital laziness, which is difficult for overcoming. Unfortunately, a lot of people usually are lazy. Next are traditions and mentality of some people. For example, our nation, Azerbaijanians, demand education of children in the spirit of full obedience by the adult. We consider children's mobility as bad manners sign. But it is not really bad money, I think. Deep studying of hypokinesia has been begun only in the middle of the 20th century. Then began to plan lasting many days and even long-term flights in space. The first spaceships were too close, and the attention to the question has been brought space medicine. How will operate on cosmonauts long compelled of hypokinesia? For the decision of this question, in the developed countries, experiments with artificial hypokinesia on volunteers have been made, though the longest experiment was planned for 120 days. In most cases, it should be stopped for 70 days because of irreversible change occurring in an organism of participants of experiment. In the course of these experiments, the constant monitoring, including the general clinical inspection, laboratory analysis, electrocardiography, electroencephalography, X-ray, myography have been established. It has been established that at long hypokinesia, the tone of a bulk of a brain that is a consequence of reduction of impulses arriving from proprioceptors, first of all, decreases. You know that in our organism there are three forms of receptors. Interoceptors are situated in internal organs. Exteroceptors are situated in our feeling organs, and proprioceptors are situated in our bones and muscles. Only reduction of impulses arriving from proprioceptors decreases, but it is enough to decrease the tone of the brain bulk. The brain bulk through subcrustal structures makes regulating impact on all human body and also on vegetative nervous system. As you know, when we are resting, parasympathetic system shows higher tone than sympathetic tone. but in conditions of long hypokinesia, shock sympathoinhibitor mechanisms and the tone of sympathetic nervous system raises. It leads to a number of changes in activity of many organs as well as cardiovascular system. So, a week of hypokinetic, mainly akinetic volunteers, heart rate had increased by 10%. In 2 weeks, 20%, and a month later, the heart rate of those volunteers became almost on 50% more than before experiment. For example, if at the beginning it was mainly about 80 heartbeats per minute, in a month it became 120 per minute. We call it tachycardia. Along with it, gradually decreased systolic volume, which after a month of experiment, in some cases had decreased more than in 2 times, and that had led to reduction of minute volume of a blood group. You know, it is very important hemodynamic and data about changes of arterial pressure was inconsistent. However, in most cases, systolic pressure decreased and diastolic remained stable. In conditions of hypokinesia, breath became superficial, rare. Gas exchange process was broken. In digestion bodies, also mechanical and fermentative function was broken. Delay of bowel movements and decrease in activity of enzymes led to digestion infringement. Appetite decreased. Occurrence in concrements, not digested elements. In the muscles, negative shifts also were observed. Hypodynamia, a reduction of muscular force and the tone of muscles, muscular hypertrophy, mobility reduction in joints, decrease in flexibility of a backbone, and so on were observed. The changes set forth above led to interstitial hypoxia, to violation of trophic processes in all tissues and organs, to delay of processes of regeneration and reparation. It in turn led even more to radical changes in all bodies and systems. Process of blood forming was slowed down, not ripened erythrocytes got into blood, activity of bodies of external and internal secretion was broken. All these negative changes finally led to violation of homeostasis. Homeostasis means a constancy of the internal environment of an organism. Violation of homeostasis, in its turn, created preconditions for development of new diseases and aggravation of available deviations in a state of health. You see that hypokinesia leads to diseases and pathologies. And I said that there are a lot of objective and subjective factors which cause hypokinesia. But why we don't are quite akinetic till now? Because each of us has kinesophilia. What means kinesophilia? Kineso means moving, philia, loving. By Magindovich, kinesophilia means congenital need for movement, which originates in the prenatal period and persists throughout the life. This is a reflex that can temporarily disappear in certain conditions, for example, in a coma, somewhat weaken with age, but it never completely disappears till the end of life. In 70s of the last century, Dr. Magindovich had been made some experiments, and he proved that all people, even in a womb of mother, have a congenital requirement for movements, which he named kinesophilia. Kinesophilia prevents full akinesia of the person. To prove existence of kinesophilia, Dr. Magindovich had made the following experiment in a kindergarten. He put special apparatus, a pedometer, into the pocket of each child. All children first day had normal usual activity. The next day, the first half of a day, they were lying in bed without movement. And in second part of the day, they could move as much as they wanted. And the pedometer, which was put into their pocket, reacted to each movement of the children. As a result of that experiment, it has been established that completely akinesia in the first part of the day had led to hyperactivity of children at the second part of the day. And consequently, in the day of experiment, the general activity of the children did not differ from the activity in the first day. And Magindovich proved the existence of kinesophilia using this experiment. Nowadays, a lot of people ask doctors the question, how much the normal adult should move in order his physical activity was considered as a rational physical activity. And today, many experts answering this question adhere to recommendations of Dr. Kenneth Cooper. His long experience has generalized in his books New Aerobics and Aerobics for Good Mood. These books were translated into Russian and you can find them in our library. Dr. Kenneth Cooper writes that after long residing at conditions of hypokinesia, the person should expand his activity gradually within 6 months. And he should divide it into 2 periods of 3 months. During the first 3 months, he should be engaged only in walking, gradually increasing a distance from 1.5 kilometers to 5 kilometers. During walking, his heart rate should be within 110 and 120 beats per minute. During the next 3 months, he should be passed gradually to run as follows: a distance of 2.5 kilometers for women and 3 kilometers for men should be divided into 100-meter sites. Odd sites he should pass on foot, he should walking, and even sites he should run. Run as jogging. It is not very quickly running. Gradually, it is necessary to reduce extent of the pedestrian distances at the expense of increase in the running. Thus, in the end of 6 months, all distance 2.5 or 3 kilometers should be overcome jogging. The heart rate at the end of 6 months during such training should reach the rate shown in this formula. Training heart rate is equal to 180 minus age of the person. For example, for 25-year-old person, heart rate should be up to 180 minus 25, it is 155 beats per minute. After the 6 months period, it is possible to continue to run or to be engaged in any sports as a fun. The main thing thus weekly to reach 27 till 30 points for men and 25 points for women. It is easily counted using the tables given in Kenneth Cooper's books. He gave such tables for the most popular kinds of sports. For example, football, volleyball, basketball, tennis, badminton, and so on. Observing rational physical activity, it is necessary to prefer aerobic loadings, such as walking, running, skating, skiing, swimming, etc., as they make the general improving impact on a human body, reduce cholesterol level in blood, raise non-specific resistibility of an organism. However, it is impossible to refuse completely and from anaerobic loadings. Anaerobic are exercises on special training apparatus. These loadings, though, increase cholesterol level in blood, and at the same time, they allow an organism not to lose speeding up qualities. How do we know is the exercise aerobic or anaerobic? It was proven in special experiments that when we begin to perform any exercises, first 15, sometimes 20 seconds, we perform this exercise using anaerobic processes, which go on without spending oxygen. But after that seconds, if the exercise let reach training heart rate shown in this formula, and if it is performing without breaking from 5 minutes till 1 or 2 hours, it is aerobic exercise. But those exercises which give maximal or submaximal loading, or are performing with braking, they are anaerobic exercises. At the same time, giving any recommendations due to rational training, you should know main principles of it. First principle is a principle of an individualization of loading. When we recommend any exercises, we should know the interests of person, the state of his health, his physical development, and so on. The next principle is regularity of trainings. Principle of regularity means that between trainings, between each next training, the break should be during the same period. But how long should be that period of breaking? It should be due to the trainings during a week. We recommend to elderly persons to train 2 or 3 times a week. For those who is between 30 and 59 years old, we recommend to train 3 or 4 times a week. And for youth, for young people, for children, we recommend trainings 4 or 5 times a week. And if we recommend anybody to train 2 times a week, and he trains on Saturdays and Sundays, and then has a break of 5 days, he will lose all positive changes which he gained during the training. The next principle is a principle of graduality. It means step by step facilitating of loading. If we don't increase the loading, we will lose the effect after several weeks or months. The next principle is a principle of systematization. It means that the person should train not during some days or some weeks. He should plan his physical training for all his life. For example, when we recommend to students to be active, to have rational physical activity, they say that they will do it during their holidays, vacation period, but it is not normal because it is a short period. After that, they will lose all gained effects. And last principle is combination of general and local training. What means local training? It is performing exercises for some groups of muscles. For example, some people want to have great muscles in upper extremities, so they perform exercises for upper extremities. It means local training, but general training involves in the training process most muscles, and that is during running, walking, performing gymnastic exercises, aerobic exercises, and so on. And combination of general and local training is very optimal for anybody. Now I want to tell you about the positive influences of physical exercises on a human body. When the exercises and the loading is normal, optimal for this person, it shows only positive effect. Positive influence of physical exercises on the vital functions of a human body is named a biological role of physical exercises. Principal views of positive influence of physical exercises are, first of all, prevention of hypokinesia and hypodynamia and compensation of their consequences. In order to prevent hypokinesia, we can sometimes use artificial means, for example, electromyostimulators. They look like a butterfly, and the specialists sometimes recommend using these stimulators when you are reading, when you are working in sitting position, for example, at the computer, and put it onto any muscle. And the stimulation of the muscle will lead to the activity of muscles. But it is artificial mean. So we recommend it only in those cases when the patient cannot perform exercises himself. Normally is using exercises. And prevention of hypokinesia and hypodynamia is very important, so we put it on the first place. The second biological role is increasing of the general non-specific resistibility of an organism. In order to understand the wave of increasing of this resistibility, you should know the theory of stress by Dr. Cellier. He showed that due to adaptation syndrome in each person, as a result of any action of factors on the organism increases the activity in hypophysis and adrenocorticotropic hormone in increased amount goes into blood, and as a result, some hormones increases in our organism, and it leads in to three stages of stress reaction. First step, first stage of this reaction is not positive because organism is not ready to this action. But when the same stressor acts on the organism repeatedly, we are ready to show normal reaction on it. And it is the most positive stage of stress reaction. In order to increase this stage and to prevent the next stage, we recommend to our athletes using adaptogens, as I said at our last lecture. Due to physical exercises, we can increase non-specific resistibility. The next is acceleration of physical development. Acceleration is the good result of physical exercises. Then active longevity. Active longevity, it begins from 90 years old, and gerontologists say that all persons who is long living persons were active from their childhood and youth, and they consider their longevity as a result of physical activity. Physical exercises increase general working capacity as well as mental capacity and physical capacity. And at last, feeling of muscular pleasure. Muscular pleasure is a very good feeling. It looks as the result of the producing in our organism, inside it, endorphins. They are like opiates, and during getting good emotions or physical activities, if it is at normal level for this organism, he should feel muscular pleasure. But now I want to tell you about negative consequences of using physical exercises. We call them specific sport pathology, like physical overstrain, which is observed in the beginning of physical activity. At beginning, athletes, when they put before themselves the unreal sports purposes, train with great overloading, and it leads to overstrain. But overtraining is observed at highly skilled sportsmen, highly skilled athletes, at intense training of persons having chronic infection. It leads to a dystrophy of a myocardium of 3 stages. And treatment of these pathologies is correction of training process and sanitation of the chronic infection centers. This was our second lecture, and thank you for your attention. See you the next lecture. Goodbye.